सोलेनॉइड ऑपरेटेड डायरेक्शन कंट्रोल वाल्व। In the normal position, figure A, the ports 1 and 2 are open, that is, the fluid from the pressurized supply, compressed air, is simply returning through the exhaust port to atmosphere. That means there is no fluid supply to the device when the solenoid is operated by passing a current through it. It magnetism and pulls the iron core towards it. This in turn moves the spool valve to right, figure B. This moment now opens the port 3 and cuts off the port 1 from 2, causing the flow from port 2 to port 3 starts. That means the device is connected to port 3, starts getting the required pressurized fluid and gets activated. When the fluid supply to the device through port 3 is to be stopped, the solenoid is deactivated by stopping the current supply to the solenoid, which in turn gets demagnetized. Then the spool is pushed back to its original position by the spring pressure. Solenoid controlled pilot operated direction control valve. The use of solenoids to operate large direction control valve is quite difficult, since large valves require higher forces to operate. Large size solenoids operating on high currents are required. To overcome this difficulty, usually the valves are pilot operated, while solenoids are used to control the pilot operations. The construction of such a valve is shown in figure above. In operation, a small capacity solenoid actuates the pilot valve. The pilot valve in turn controls the pneumatic supply to the direction control valve. Since the pilot valve can control large supplies of air, the direction control valve can be actuated easily. Advantages: small capacity solenoids can be used. AC solenoids can be used at low current levels, which improves contact life of the relays. Since low currents are used, the temperature rise is low and thus failure of solenoids burnout is minimum. Control circuit for single acting cylinder. In this solenoid controlled 3x2 direction control valve, 3 position 2-way is used to actuate the single acting cylinder. It is a spring return cylinder, hence it is actuated by pneumatic power in the extension mode. The solenoid is energized by a manual switch, which in turn operates the normally closed direction control valve. By this, the pressure line is directed to the cylinder port to cause the cylinder actuation. When the switch is released, the valve returns to normally closed position, by which the cylinder port is directed to the exhaust line. The cylinder then returns back under the spring pressure. This is the diagram of control circuit for single acting cylinder. D, electric switch. S, solenoid.